Hello, my name is Hannes Gislason, and I'm from the Aquaculture Research Station of the Faroes, and I'm the head of research, not the head of the institute.
We have the system with
yes,
2 minutes.
Yes, I have noticed.
Thank you.
I will talk about cod farming as a sustainable alternative to captured cod. The overview of my talk is that I will talk about the question of to capture cod or to farm cod, because that may very well be the future question, or at least to farm and to fish cod. I will talk about environmental conditions for cod farming here in the Faroe Islands and in other countries. And I will talk about challenges in cod farming, R&D plans for cod farming, and cod farming in other countries, and finally, results from cod farming in the Faroe Islands. Let's start by discussing this question of to farm cod instead of fishing cod. There's a lot of information here, but let's try to look first at this graph, which shows the total seafood production in the world from fisheries and from fish farming. And from 1950 to 2000, what you see is that the blue area is the captured seafood, and the red area is the farmed seafood, and it is increasing dramatically in the last years as compared to fisheries, which are reaching a plateau. The aquaculture is seen more here, the increase from 1990 to 2005. Don't worry about the different colors, that's just the different species, but you see that the production from 1990 to 2005 has increased from around 50 million tons to around 65 million tons. The situation in fisheries is quite the opposite, at least for cod. If you look at this graph, you see that the total, again, don't worry about the colors, that's just the different countries, but if you look at the total production, it has declined quite dramatically in this period from 1990 to 2005. And as we heard yesterday from the Icelandic fishery minister, they have cut quotas quite dramatically for cod fisheries in Iceland by one third. The Canadians have even stopped to fish cod, and in some countries, consumers are stopping buying cod because they think it's not a sustainable species, the fisheries of it. Maybe we could do something about that with aquaculture. But let's first look locally at the Faroese cod fisheries. That's the bottom graph here. The bottom curve is the fisheries of cod in the Faroes from 1993 to 2007. And what you see is that it is highly variable, with a mean value around 24,000 tons, but the variation is of the order of 10,000 tons. The upper curve is just included fisheries of cod in foreign waters also. You also see the last years we are way below the average. And maybe we could improve this production of cod by also including farm cod. Let's look at the question more clearly. Could we farm cod in Faroe Islands? This is from a recent report from Iceland about cod farming, where they have looked at environmental conditions for cod farming in various countries. They score important parameters for cod farming, like the mean sea temperature, variations in sea temperature, sea waves and currents, sea ice, and etc. And they weight the temperatures most by 40 and 20%. And here are the countries: West Iceland, East Iceland, Norway, West Norway, North Norway, Faroes, Scotland, and Canada. And what you see overall is that the Faroes score get the highest score, overall score, especially from the good temperatures, low variations in sea temperature. The scale goes to 10, but we score low on sea waves and currents because we all know we have high waves and currents here. But overall, we score highest close with West Norway. You see, Scotland is also reasonably good, but Iceland scores much lower, mostly because of low sea temperatures and because of problems with icing. The variations in sea temperature are quite low in the Faroes. This is seen by this curve. The red curve is measured in Nesvik in 2007, where the temperature only drops to around 6 degrees and to around, the top is around 10 degrees in 1 year. But in Norway, it can go much higher, and in Iceland, it can go much lower. And both of those cases are bad for the growth of cod. However, there are big challenges in cod farming. Especially, there are challenges in survival, cannibalism of the cod, and various production problems, escapes, and etc. Early sex maturation stops the growth of the cod, and various diseases. This has resulted in the most cod farming companies have negative profits in Norway. And there is a strong need for increased research and development to reduce production costs. This table here shows revenue and profits and harvest plans for cod farms in Norway, where you see that the revenues in the profit in 2006 is negative for most cod farming companies. However, the harvest plans on the right part of the table shows that they are they expect a dramatic increase in harvest. This reflects their optimism in that this industry will be profitable. How did cod farming start or take off? I think we can start by looking at R&D plans for cod farming, where in Norway, it started around 2001, where Innovation Norway and the Norwegian Research Council made plans for cod farming and made recommendations for actions. And in Iceland, it started around the same time, 2002, where the Icelandic Marine Institute made plans for cod farming. They have recently released a report here in 2007 about recommendations for actions in Iceland about cod farming. In Faroe Islands, we have the aquaculture research station, and we have a small trial project for 2 years, which I will talk about the results from it here today, and they will be reported here in 2008. If you look at what is happening right now, the interest for cod farming, I have listed two industry journals, which from Norsk Fiskeoppdrett claim that there will be a cod boom in 2 years' time. And fish farming expert claims that Icelanders go for cod in an article series. But if you look at the real production, what is happening right now, we can look at what the volumes of farm cod in Norway. In this strategy period, it has increased from almost nothing to around 13,000 tons in 2007, and it is expected to grow by around 35,000 tons in 2009. If you want to compare this to some other numbers, this value is comparable to the farmed salmon in the Faroes this year. Other countries in cod farming are much lower in volume than Norway, but most importantly is Iceland, which also has managed to increase its volume in their period of strategy for cod farming to around 1,500 tons. And other countries are much smaller in volume. And if you just mention Faroes, we are just starting and hoping to get a small production in 2008. And maybe it will increase to about 1,000 tons in 2010.